Hello. I'm Oriana from Zyxel Networks. Welcome back to another exciting TECHtalk episode of our Zyxel SCR 50AXE series. We're thrilled to have you join us as we delve deeper into the remarkable capabilities of this cutting-edge security router. In this episode, we will be discussing how you can take full advantage of your SCR's threat report page. Cyberattacks are not always a result of a user attempting to browse a website containing malicious content. Some cyberattacks involve infecting your computers or smart devices operating system. Some of these infections can be very obvious and easily noticed by your users, such as the case of DOS or ransomware attacks. But other malwares are more subtle. They can be a simple script that creates unauthorized VPN tunnels between your device and proxy servers. A user could be sending their private data directly to a malicious user without ever realizing this. This can happen if the user decides to work outside the office without a security router or firewall. For instance, the user could simply have installed the malware when browsing at home or while working at a cafe, or even from simply borrowing someone's USB storage device. With threat management, the SCR will still guarantee that even a compromised client will be unable to access proxy servers or phishing websites. But this doesn't really fix the issue. The user's device is still infected and completely vulnerable when used outside your office or could still have modified some core system functions. In that case, we can use Threat Report to detect whether a client's system has potentially been compromised. You can find the Threat Report page either on the Nebula web portal or your Nebula mobile app. But for this episode, we will be focusing on how to use Threat Report on the latter. We start by reviewing the number of hits in the last 24 hours. This can be found on the main dashboard of your Nebula site. A hit is detected anytime the SCR prevents a client from accessing an unsafe website or server. This can happen naturally when users browse websites with various links or advertisements. Should the user carelessly click on a link that contains malicious content, the page would be blocked by your SCR. Afterwards, users would simply move on after seeing a blocked web page or pop-out window. This is why a few hits is considered acceptable and should not be a cause for worry. On the other hand, we might witness a threat event that has very high hit counts. Note that the scale of your threat events changes according to the highest number of hits in the last 24 hours. This is where we can start suspecting that something isn't quite right. So let's assume that we are the network administrator of a small office, and this is what we see on the Nebula app's dashboard. We tap on the Threat Events panel to redirect us to the Nebula mobile app's Threat Report page. The Threat Report page arranges the threat category with the highest hit count starting from the top. We can see that there are hits for ransomware and email frauds. However, the low hit counts may just suggest that some users have accidentally or carelessly clicked on these URLs. We can ignore this since the SCR continues to protect these clients from actually accessing the harmful web contents. However, the block VPN proxy shows an unusually high hit count. We can tap on this category to learn more about this report. By clicking the threat category, we can see a list of all clients that have hit this threat category. These clients are arranged from highest to lowest hit counts. We can ignore the low hits from Alice's phone. But the clients with over 1,000 hits in the last 24 hours will be harder to ignore. This is most likely a sign of clients with a compromised software. The client called Chris Desktop is pretty straightforward. Since this name is taken directly from the host computer, we can conclude that the device belongs to our coworker, Chris. We can simply confront Chris in the office and ask if he can run an anti-malware software on his computer. But what about the other compromised client? Now comes the problem. This client does not or may not even be designed to provide a host name. So how exactly do we know what, or where, this device is? Is it a computer? A handheld device? Or one of the various office appliances? Who does it belong to? To find the answer, we could ask every single employee to check the MAC addresses of their surrounding devices and hopefully find the compromised device. With enough time and effort, finding the client is inevitable. On the other hand, we can work more efficiently by continuing our investigation with our threat reports. By looking closely at the list of clients, we see that the operating systems are displayed on the list. We know that one device is most likely a computer running Windows, while the other one could be an iPhone due to the Apple logo. However, the compromised client shows a generic icon. This means the client is not running under a well-known OS like Windows, Mac, or Android. Let's tap on the client to see what other information we can learn about this client. First, we can see that this client is online. This means that the client should still be in the office. Besides, there also doesn't seem to be any Wi-Fi related information like SSID name or Wi-Fi signal that normally appears with wireless clients. So we can now conclude that the client is a wired client. We can continue our investigation again by scrolling down the client information page. Here we can see the final piece of the puzzle. MCC recognizes the client's manufacturer based on its hardware information. In this case, MCC determined that the client is manufactured by a company called TerraPrint Solution. With all the intel we gathered, we can now distinguish that the compromised device is most likely our office printer. At this point, you should contact the repair center of this manufacturer to reformat or reinstall its operating system. But sometimes, the repair center may not be available immediately. So while we wait for our repairman, we can follow this up with two more actions in our Nebula mobile app. We make sure that the client does not cause any harm to the network by setting its policy to blocking for now. Next, we change the name of this client to something more recognizable by tapping the edit button at the top of the client information. That way, when the device has been repaired and returned to the office, we can easily identify the device from the list in order to unblock the client. Well, that's it for today's Tech Talk. Hope this episode was able to give you an idea of how to take advantage of your SCR's threat report page. Like, comment, and subscribe. And I hope to see you in our next episode. Have a nice day.
We're Zyxel, and we're your networking ally.